in years past, we've always given free police shots to county employees. Most of them don't even go in, but some of them do, so I don't know if you guys want to go ahead and do that.
What's the cost for the public if they?
I don't know.
It's not $10, is it?
They're pretty cheap.
Yeah, it's, and it's, I mean, as far as county, I think it's cost effective.
Well, I do too, but I just was curious, what is the cost?
But it's not mandatory.
You don't know what Doris never said, but I don't think they charge very much for them anyway.
She told us it last year, but I don't remember.
The majority are Medicare, Medicaid, so.
Like I said, not everybody takes them, but there's a few that do.
It ought to be cost effective for keeping people at work.
Yeah.
If they work. And not getting sick. That's fine.
Okay, we're done. No, Carl's having it. You got minutes to approve.
Make a motion to approve the minutes of October 8th.
A second.
Okay, we have a motion and a second to approve the minutes from October 8th meeting. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Motion carried.
And I have the, we have to amend the budget, so for Philip, for that money he got. So we'll publish that next week, and the hearing will be November 5th. If you see that in the paper, amending his budget so he can spend $40,000 more. I think he's gonna crush that rock with that, is what he said.
Oh, that's federal.
Mm-hmm. That's all I have.
When's Carl coming?
I told him to be here at 8:30, but I didn't think he'd be here long.
We'll recess for now.
You're fine, I got, I'll get time.
We got time.
So did they.
I have a couple things I was gonna go over. One would be pictometry. I didn't know if you guys wanted to see it or not. You don't have the property lines because we can't see people's property, but you can see the photography and so forth.
Where's the picture, though?
It would be Saline County, or we can jump over to Riley. And what I did is I kind of look at Brookville, because they would be at 9 inch like our three counts, all our counts would be. But Saline is at 3 inch, if you want to see some 3 inch on there.
Oh, sorry. Days.
Who knows?
You call it.
Yeah.
He probably called saying that.
And kind of, trying to do this from the side here, or Shane, you can do it, one of the two there. This here, what I'm showing you here is this is Orion. This would be another parcel. And this is what we've added recently. That's little map tab here. And what that does, and whatever parcel we had pulled up in that part, in that corner, would be this here particular parcel. And this just happened to be the part out here on the center here. Hopefully this internet's working more than it is, all right. But what this would do is the pictometry would come in and take the place of our photography, which this is what we have here. Now, what would be nice about this is we can pretty well go in through the pictometry's WebEx, or with this here, we can actually, if you're in Orion, you can actually still get the pictometry without getting into their WebEx, because this is going to convert over to here. Now, one thing that we talked to Saline County and Riley County, because we've called them, when you get down to where you have the angle to look at the different sides, the streets don't line up very good, which kind of makes sense, because you're looking at an angle now, so the streets are kind of, but when you back off of that angle, then the streets line back up again. And I asked them how good they were, and they said they were pretty good, but just review it. So so we are going to, we'll review it and so forth. But this here, this is kind of what we have right here. This is where the ortho, we just look down on the top of the roof and from the top bottom, top down. Minimize that. You would come over here then, and we would just keep zooming in. Now, when you come in, then you're going to get, like, kind of like you showed, you're going to get those tick marks on there, and then you can go from the square down here would be on the ortho, that would be on the very top. That's what we would, that's what we're used to looking at, straight down on there. And then if you want to come in to something else, or if you want to zoom in. And that's real close. If you notice on ours, we had three blocks. That was the closest we could get on there. And then this here gets pretty close. That would be right there. That's pretty close. We can get closer, and then if you want to see this particular building from the back side, then that would be the back side up in there instead of from that side, or if you go from one angle to the other. So this here is pretty close because we're within a block. That would be, if we was looking at that on the square, you would just see the square here in town. Is how close that would be.
But that's about as close as you can get.
You can get closer.
Let's get more room.
At one point then.
We're up to the plus sign.
It will start getting a little blurrier.
Even though your picture is blurry, can you still measure?
Yes.
Like he was showing that it's accurate at that point?
Yes, it is. It is. And if we go back to that side. You can see. Now what's nice in the rural, if we can look at the rural shows up really good. I think mostly because of the size of things.
Mm-hmm.
And that's a pretty good photo right there on there. And then if you want to, now if you want to go back and look at the 3-inch, there's the bicentennial building right there. Then you see, I mean, it shows up good because it's big. And I think that's why in the demonstrations they use K-State or KU because it's big and it does show up very well. But you can pull, you can get down pretty close to 3. Now that's pretty close to photo right there. Mm-hmm. The reason being, if you look at a comparison of what we looked at in St. John, we seen 3 blocks as close as we can get. You got one building. And it's not by far as long as a block is. So that's pretty close right there. And he jumps that way. But then, one thing that, you know, we talked about with because of the barn was consumed with Google Pro, you know, you have some functions you can do also and so forth. The photos, what they thought is, they thought the Comptree's photos was better than Google's. And they even liked it with the leaf off, because with the leaf on, you can't see some things and some of their side alleys and so forth like that. But the big thing that I think that is important is, with Google, you're not going to get the property lines. I don't think, I hope it never comes, I hope they never request, because I don't want Google to have our property line. Because when you give something Google, it's open. But you need that very first layer to do anything, even for zoning. If you don't have the property lines, where are you going to measure your radius for your zoning that compiles all the properties that's involved with the issue? You don't know where to start and where to end. And one thing, you know, that the Comptree doesn't have, that Google does, is that street view. You know, the street view, you can walk up and down the street pretty much. But when you get that close, because we was going to measure and see how close it was, all their functions go off. You can't do anything at that point. You can't measure heights of pole, you can't measure heights of, you can't do anything at that point. It's just a view type thing. So that's kind of the common part. So, you know, when we talked about the 3-inch and 9-inch, and the city's going to the 9-inch, it's still going to be where we're within 3 blocks. This is going to get you into about half a block at 9-inch. It's still going to be real close there. So what I was going to ask you guys, I think we're down to, I think Pawnee is going to have one more meeting in with the county people, kind of like we did here, to make sure they're going to use it. They're not going to ask them, they're going to say, you need to use this if we're going to do this, is what they're going to confirm there. And then they're probably signing the contract. I was going to go over some of that with you. I did make up a contract for each city, if you want to look at that. It's not really a contract, but it's kind of a, where they would know what their costs would be to the county.
What is their cost going to, I mean, we talked about that. What's their cost going to entail, I guess?
Okay, this is, I mean, all three cities are the same. I don't know who has what.
St. John's,
St. John's, and Maxville. Their price, because they're all 9 sectors, their price is going to be the same on there. What this would show then is the 9 sectors, the cost. The Pictometry Connect, that's kind of our, I think they should all pay for part of that Connect so we can get in here. And then the 9-inch Mr. Sid format. The media drive capacity, that's actually going to be part of that drive that we have, the hard drive. And I'm not sure where we want to keep it. Nita might be, maybe Nita's vault or somewhere like that. But that would be helpful for when, if there would be a disaster and the courthouse would be down, we could go get that disk and then we'd go live again on there. That's the advantage of that. And then what it would do is their total cost would be $3,598. And then if they look at their installment, their first installment, if we was flown in March, their installment, they would owe you, the county, $1,199.33 in the second year and third year. And then what they would do after that, from 2018 and on, is, because we're going to continue with the program, even though the photography and everything's paid for now, but we still have our connection fee and so forth, is their fee would be around $700 from then on. And what that would include of, and this is where I think, Shane, you had the concern on this, is, and talking to the city, I think they are kind of interested in maybe doing their layers and working more themselves, and then when they're done or need help, give it to Merrill, and then we ship it off to the Pictometry on there. But this would include, so there's no questions asked later. I tried to put some things in there This would all include the pictometry imagery, the property lines, the center lines, the city limits, the streets. We would help them with one layer a year on the average. And then we would make them four maps, which they're going to want to map. Once they get a layer done, probably, they, you know, if they're streets or something, they're probably going to want a map to hang in their city office to use it. We can make four maps a year. Anything after that, then, we would just do a minimum charge by $35. That would be for the ink and for the paper. Everything else would be included. We wouldn't have little bills coming back and forth mm-hmm. between us. I really didn't want that.
How much time will that take of your employees?
Well, you know, it's the layers, once we get rolling, you know, like, because they're not big cities, just like the manholes, it won't be that strenuous. I kind of got some of that information from Saline County. Burtville didn't take
very long to do.
It just doesn't take that long to do the layer. The water lines or so forth would take a little longer. But once again, we can't do that. We would have to have the city, because we don't know where they're at.
Right.
You know, the same way with Phil wanting to layer for the bridge, of course, his county. Phil would have to do a lot of legwork, and then he would get that information, and then Maryland could do it. And our time wouldn't be that consuming then, because he would have done the harder part. So I think we'd be all right there. Where we were at then, this is the first five pages of our contract. And what I did is I kind of, to see where, now if you guys wanted to do this, well, we're going to do these five pages. The second page would show that this would be the contract between Stafford County and Pictometry. Remember, you guys are signing a contract, nobody else will sign a contract with Pictometry. The third page is going to get into part of how I came up with the prices. I highlighted the bill two, because I don't know if you right now, they just put me in the appraiser's office. I don't know if you want to change that to Nita and the clerk's office as the bill come in or something, or pay. That's whatever you guys want to do there. It's your contract on that. It shows the first flight and the second flight, which we're going to, you know, like you said, we can postpone that second flight all the way past the 6 years. I highlighted some things here in case the cities want to question how we come up with the bill. I did it mostly for how I did that thing. And then we did divide it by the four between the county and the three cities and so forth. Now, that doesn't mean Hudson doesn't want a map or doesn't want something or sewer. The only difference is they will pay per map. And they won't have to.
What will that charge be, do you know yet?
Well, it's looking like probably around $450, Shane, to be honest with you. Which they may do one time every 2 years or something.
Yeah.
That would be better for those small towns.
Have you talked to Pete about that?
No, not on Pictometry. Mostly when I talk to Pete, it's about zoning.
Right.
But not on that. But it would. They would be. The only difference would be Hudson, Stewart, and Radium would be four sectors. And so their price would be cheaper, but they would still they'd still spend, you know, X amount of dollars to where if they could just get a map or a layer, then they just pay us and go that route and build that back up again. On your, I think it's your last page, it kind of breaks down where we would be on fees. Our original one, when he gave it to us, was $73,000. It's $57,000 now after we got the sectors narrowed down on what we wanted, what we didn't want. There's a couple things in the original contract that we didn't need. For the future view of full conference, what that was is if we wanted to go to Vegas for a conference. We don't need that. We might want to go, but we don't need to, you know what I mean? So we took some things out of this that we didn't need to get that price narrowed back down there. what would happen then, and I put it in pencil over to your left, there's an $8,539.37. That's what we would pay on the sign. We both have signed the contract. That would be what one says due at signing. But those two things is what we would pay currently. Then the next thing is due at initial shipment of inventory. We would, if they flew in March, we would get that probably in April or what have you. So that would be the $13,558.13. That would be our March payment, and then our next two payments would be come thereafter at each time of each year. The total between the three cities, I think, is about $10,000. One thing I think we need to do, if we're going to do this, we probably need to can't wait on the Great Bend anymore, is he's going to meet with them the 27th, I think, to confirm which way they're going. But he did say, now that's not included in the cities, but that they would still give us the 5% even though we signed. We're waiting on them. But how long do you wait? Mm-hmm.
So the cities are paying like $10,500 of the 57.
So we would be about 14,000 over a 3-year period, 14,000-15,000.
And the second project would pay for that when we do that?
If you remember, he kept saying, if you don't have it, and Ruth did make a comment that she's going to put in theirs that, something about it, you have to put a term in there if the funds are available or something like that.
That's what I was wondering.
Otherwise, the county's liable to pay the entire thing. So she was going to add that sentence to the contract if funds are available. That way you can go from 1 year to the other. The clerks know that. So.
Well, have you showed this to Jim?
No.
Yeah, you can show it to Jim.
And this here is the folder for that. So what I wanted to see where we were at then, and I thought about taking the cities there, but I think since we're initiating it, I won't take it to them until at least we sign. And then we can show that we have intent of doing this. I think they would feel more comfortable if we sign before they do.
Probably.
They might want more specifics on that little part about exactly what that includes. I might spell that out, I don't know.
Well, you've met with most of the cities, mm-hmm. haven't you? Mm-hmm.
This here actually came in a little lower than what we anticipated. The letter from Maxville is they was going to attribute $7,500 in a 3-year period to this. And I think staffing was kind of the same way. When we met with St. John the other night, my preliminary was showing this year was going to be about $4,500, but it still came in a little lower. So
I'm just saying that probably needs to be spelled out because you could have a change in who's on the city
council.
That's
what I wonder. You can have a change on the city council and they say, mm-hmm. we don't want to do this anymore.
Mm-hmm. Well, that's a 3-year contract, basically.
Well,
but if they entered into the contract,
you might have to have Joe
write it out more in a contract.
Okay. You don't have these back.
But it's true.
Just making copies of it. Don't get in your original
template. Yeah. Okay.
What is, my idea is let's proceed with it, but my question is where did the money come from?
I mean, it's not that much. I thought it was going to be one big fight. I didn't realize it was going to be spread out. Mm-hmm. So.
They probably let you pay one big fight if you want to.
Get another discount.
It was just an option for most counties. Can't do that. They can use it for them.
If we did pay the one, would there be a better discount?
I can ask him. Now John is going to come out the 27th to Pawnee in case there are some more questions. I don't know if I can get him to hang around till the 29th. I don't know if I was here or anything. Probably not. Just let Joe look at this and then get back with you ourselves. And,
okay.
Very good.
Probably does come over to Pawnee County for one or two.
Sure. I didn't think about that. We've seen it. I think it's a great tool.
Every year gonna be.
The partner head we have, you know, they think it's a necessity, so. Okay. You want those back?
Sure.
Was it unless you want it?
Wow.
Okay. Don't.
I'm gonna look at it.
You'll find your own house?
Yeah.
I figured that, you said Salina.
It's gone.
It's gone. And Walmart's still on top of it.
Okay, Debbie.
So you just click on the flower?
Yeah. Good, and then she'll bring it back down. And then you want to zoom back out, but she knows Salina really, really.
I know Salina pretty well.
Can you just type in the address?
I didn't have that, try it.
I can't reach.
I know, it's really hard, but I'm a mouse person too.
Yeah.
What?
It probably would fall under capital on group.
About,
Your own guest.
Yeah, that'd be the only, that's what I was thinking.
Can't you spend that for anything you want?
Yeah.
But can't we move money, I mean, pay for this now and then move money back over to that later?
Ask Amber about that too.
Now, if you guys think the, and I guess some counties in the state have done this now, if the sheriff's department uses it, and I think we might have talked on that a little bit.
Sheriff?
If the sheriff's department uses it, and they all supposedly, from what I understand, they all have a drug fund, that they can actually pay, some of the sheriff's departments are paying for it out of that, as long as the sheriff's department is using it, because they can spend it for technology and so forth. So that'd be an option.
I talked to Jeff the other day, and he was very interested in it, because he asked me about where we were at on it, where we got, you know, what our intentions were. That's something to research, though.
Okay.
We'll figure it out.
Okay. All right.
Where there's a will, there's a way, probably.
The other thing is the KAC, Association of Counties, their meeting's coming up, and I think you guys are all going.
Kurt's our speaker.
Okay. I did get the candidate
plan for a year.
The draft.
I emailed you guys the legislative draft. Did you get it?
It didn't make a statement.
I read it.
I disagree with one part of it.
They opened this here, or all of it?
Well, I disagree with their Medicare and Medicaid.
Oh, you did read it.
I knew he would. I knew the other two wouldn't even open the email, but I knew Kurt would read it.
I don't think I got it.
Yes, you did.
Twice. In this case, he sent it to you.
Oh, I didn't know if they had your emails or not.
Oh, yeah, they sent it to
did
you.
Did they?
No, they don't send me nothing.
Okay, but.
Really, I get all the KAC stuff, and then you send it again.
Well, I didn't know if you got it or not.
Yep, I should reply to you, but yeah, I got it.
Okay,
I was going to have Joe look at this, and this is kind of where we're at on that statute with the low.
You're selling for your house.
You got neighbors.
Neighbors.
Okay, and without the bold is what we added.
This used to be.
And then we marked through on A what there was. But what it would do, and it kind of came across as talking to people and so forth like this, this might be a better way to go than saying just we want to, for 5 barrels and anything under 5 barrels a day production, we go on the tax rule depending on what the price of the barrel is. Talking to some people and so forth, the lowest of the stripper wells should maybe automatically still be exempt. And then from like 2.01 barrels to 5 barrels, then it would have the two-fold. If it fell below $50 per barrel, then those would be exempt. And what we would like to see then is kind of reading of something like this.
So you kind of got three different levels there.
Yeah. And then anything above that, $50 a barrel, the 2 barrels or less would still be exempt.
possible.
And I talked to CIC, I've talked to Manitron, but not CIC. Manitron, they're kind of looking to see how much, what they would have to do to make sure this would work. So they're looking, I want to call CIC and see how quick or what would happen or how quick they could do this if it took place.
Well, I know CIC, if this does pass, they'll get right on it. Mm-hmm. They're real good with our stuff. If it gets changed, they get it changed.
So Manitron's kind of working on it.
But if they had a heads up, yeah, they could kind of.
It looks like, was this in a statute before? And is this what the law?
Yes, that is the statute.
And then you just marked out.
What's
what
there?
What year I changed.
And in bolded what was added. And then, as you can see down here, part of this statute is the dates, as I think that is important on here. This statute was brought up in 1992, and the only time it was revised is in 1998. And what happened in 1998 is they added the 5 barrels to it. So this thing hasn't been touched from then on. Now, the history of the last 10 years, and the last one was probably 5 years ago when Reno County got involved, they wanted to abolish the whole thing. Mm-hmm. Well, that's really for sure not going to fly. Mm-hmm. And talking to our people, we're not sure we need that to fly because we don't want our stripper wells to be shut down if something happens. We need them.
Be a pretty good compromise, I would think.
So I think this is the first time. If you bring this up, this will be the first time this has been brought up at a barrel dollar amount and not just abolishing it, because we don't want to do that. I don't know how you guys feel, but I don't think we want to do that.
I think there'll be a lot of them shut down if you see that.
So are you going to send it to PAC then, or has it been done?
It's on.
That's what it said. You're our speaker.
So we got to bring it up at the meeting.
Yes. The 13th.
Are you going to be there?
Yes. I went ahead and registered there. Okay. The 13th is the discussion. That's when we bring it up. And then the 14th is when. And in the meantime, you know, I'm going to try to get a hold of some people and see if we have some proponents for this already that could be players in it.
You might as well get a hold of a few legislators around here. And then, like Terry Bruce would be a good one in Reno County or something like that.
Okay. He would be a good one, though.
Terry would be a good one. Yeah. I'm not so sure he's not in charge. And the chairman of the Energy Committee, anything.
Okay.
He's from Reno County, he's an attorney.
Let me ask you this. Would it look all right if I call him, or do you need to do that? I mean, some of these people don't want the preachers calling them. They want somebody else to call them.
I could call him. I know.
There's the only thing I'm on. Now, I'm kind of treading down.
You could say I'm calling on behalf of the commissioners. You might not know about that.
Or being, you know. And like I said, we're not, we don't have the best reputation with the legislature and so forth anyway, so.
I could visit, I could call Terry.
Okay. And then on the wind, we got the wind in place and got that kind of like this here, what we need revised, and so that would go. With Ellsworth then. So. Well, I'll leave that with you guys if you see any problem with it or anything, and then I'll show this to Joe when I'm showing him the contract here. That was kind of my game plan. And we'll go from there.
Sounds good.
Did you find it?
No, I'm lost. I was trying to find Edward's end.
He's got pins stuck everywhere.
You got what?
It's a red pin stuck by this one house.
You want my house?
Are you in the close there?
That's probably for the long walk.
Brett, and it's me and fun. Brett and the ambulance.
And used to live there?
Yeah. And the height, South High is off to the, John and Barbara.
Who?
John and Barbara.
Sam, they're Sam.
Here's, okay, here's Edward.
They each own half of it. Is that the high, that's a high school.
Wow. Just right one second.
So, right at the corner.
Two people on that church.
Here's Edward's.
More prisoners.
Lots of prisoners.
Edward and Brett.
They were yesterday or something.
Should be. A little recess.
Yeah.
We'll adjourn.